Bright awoke in the womb. He twisted it in his foot. His body was dead, but the memories of his death. But dying wasn't something new for him. He looked at the amulet around his neck that granted his immortality. He stood up. There was already the voice inside his head, wanting to kill, but for now, he was in control. I would have taken him on anyway, but I will take you up on that offer, Guardian. With that, the Guardian ran to his. Their hands touched his back. He could feel the energy flowing through his body, like touching a switch. He could see beyond the illusions of this world. Taking a step, he reached out to her. Amelie, Sophia, and Alicia were sitting in the office, planning the meeting with the trade company. Jack was in the workshop. Lucas could see that Jack started to build his own steam engine. That was something he expected, but then again, Jack was from the best blacksmith in the capital. But with that, Lucas returned to his body. White left his flat to report back to the head of the bounty hunter guild that gave him the assignment. He entered the city like so many times before. This time, something was off. Someone was watching his step. He drew his gun. Lucas reached the city of the nameless. It was a late first. As he expected, the guild was the biggest building there. If the hunter told the truth in the cave, someone is paying him. It was nearly too late. Lucas quitted the bomb. White stopped walking after entering shooting distance. The arrow started moving. The gun deflected the arrow, losing its functionality in the process. Everyone that saw the arrow left the street. "Didn't I kill you?" asked Bright Lucas. "Ralph Johnson." "Strange. I would have sworn the same thing." That Lucas could finally see the amulet around my finger. "If that isn't SCP-963, Doctor Jack Bright," Lucas stated. "Well, you could call me that for now." With that, Dr. Bright's body had reminded of the other voice. "I just don't know for how long, but I don't think that's why you are here." The other part took over. He pulled out a small screen. "This is not my policy, but this is where I will finish the job." He threw the spear into the air. All life around the sea started to disappear. Lucas could see it, but he didn't move. It moved like a wave around him. He could feel the strength of his magic weaken. White stood at the edge, waiting for his victim to die. They looked into each other's eyes. Dead, Lucas smiled. Around that space started to shake. No. The space was that moved. Small lines appeared in the air, crossing each other. Each crossing created more lines. After a few seconds, broke the screen. "My body is made of swords." In a moment, life returned. Lucas filled the empty space with swords. Every single one targeted blind. He couldn't wait. The other part stopped him. "This won't stop me." Lucas moved between the swords to close the distance. He could see that the two points were fully connected, meaning That was an easy way out. With that, the priest reached the amulet. He built the jackpot of the foundation and could see the line of the jackpot of this world. Along his own soul to be the sword that divided the birds. The priest cut the bound, the two birds split apart. This first bird was the first to get back on his feet. Lucas was expecting it. He created a replica of Bright's gun and shot him in the chest, then the head. You killed him? How? Jack asked. Lucas created a special fire to destroy the corpse. I didn't. He was at the moment he brought you into this world, Jack. Your immortality prevented his body from staying dead. So, I kept the connection, you know, that Queen and Len traveled from our PC. In any case, we should get you home. We've bought some eggs, such as SCP-963. I mean, your current body is already breaking apart. So, the two started to leave the city. Jack talked about his son as a researcher at the foundation. He was assessing a spatial anomaly as he got teleported to this world. After talking, I was quite surprised that the boy knew about so many classified information. But then again, it's a different narrative. They reached his house without any further incidents. It wasn't difficult to find a place where Bright entered this world. The space around Anomaly was rejecting it. He got analyzed with his magic. There was a path leading away from this world. He put Bright and touched the Anomaly. Both got sucked into it. Lucas revealed his body disappearing in the nothingness of. He noticed the glow of SCP-963. He grabbed it. The amulet allowed him to find the path. A few steps more, and he appeared in the testing chamber of the foundation. The three defense personnel stepped back as Roy took SCP-963 and put it on the closest one. Lucas regained full control of his body. That is something I want to repay again. He remarked while looking at the two defense personnel. Then they noticed it. The outside was under lockdown. A containment breach started just minutes ago. But used his authority as the site director to leave the chamber. Lucas followed. He could already hear the sounds of guns a few corridors away. Then they reached the MTF, responsible for the sounds, while they tried to contain it. Lucas looked at it now. That was something that he didn't expect when the day began, but he was looking at it. SCP-073-2 came closer with a sword in one hand and a white look in the eyes. Right, ordered the MTF to stop shooting. Lucas approached him. Replicating the sword of his foe. His sword broke as they clashed. In the next moment, a new sword appeared, blocking SCP-076-2 in the last moment. The same thing happened multiple times, each time a bit faster. More electric shocks filled the corridor, forcing Bright and the MTF to retreat. Then, Abel got the upper hand. In one unexpected move, he let Lucas stab him to close the gap and form into a wall. Lucas took Udo Wong, thinking that the able turned around to attack the MTN. Lucas could feel his body. Every broken bone, the damage on his organ. He knew that a normal human would be dead by now, but that wasn't his style. So he forced his arms to push the stones above him away. Then he noticed that he was laying in the remains of a bunch of lumber. What caught his attention was a pair of gloves. Five was next to him. SCP-311. Lucas put them on. The effects are routine to move his hands without problems. So he stood up and forced his body forward. Evil had problems grabbing his sword, but that didn't stop him from noticing Lucas. With that, he started to charge him. Lucas allowed the rest of his magic to enter the gloves and flat his hands. A shockwave went through Abel, leading him to spit out a big amount of blood. Lucas' wounds disappeared in the same moment. Lucas used the return of his strength to hit the wall as much force as possible. Abel's right hand got ripped apart, so Abel decided to drop his weapon and attack with what's left of his hand. Lucas took a boxing stance. Each of his hits had doubled the impact. And Abel had to deal with the attack itself and the effect of SCP being on one. Which wouldn't be a problem, but he on one's effects encapsulated Lucas' entire body. The longer the fight went on, the weaker it was able. Till his body reached its limit and expired. Lucas took off the gloves and handed them to Bert. Don't worry, I removed the enchantment. They are back to before I touched them. Lucas started to feel the effects of the magic he had already cast. This world had its own trauma tragedy, but it was not a fan of his interference and started to reject him. But I'm going to close the connection between the two worlds. With that, we started to walk towards the test chamber. Word followed. Already, you could stay a lot near here. There are a lot of questions I want to ask you. Lucas showed his right hand. Weak blueprint started to cover his hand. The same goes for me, but for now, I will remove the connection. But who knows? Maybe we will meet again. Till then, and with that, Lucas left this world. Dr. Pride looked at the place that I normally was before. With the disappearance of the wall, the anomaly closed, leaving nothing more than what in a report about his trip. To the other world after he finished his report. He got a message that Abel returned, so Bart decided to add a last interview to his report before submitting it to the database. Lucas didn't return to the house, but to the waterfall. The guardian was waiting for him. Or better said, he was laying in her lap. It took a bit of effort and her hand, but Lucas managed to get back on his feet. And when it comes to him, wouldn't wake up anymore. She said with an almost disappointed voice. At first, you disappear for a few hours, and then you come back more dead than anything. If I hadn't got you here, you couldn't be breathing anymore. I mean, you lay there for a few days, he shouted. A few days, Lucas thought. He allowed his mind to wander off and found the army. 3 days were left before the meeting with the trading company. Then Gideon brought him to the training school from which he entered their world the first time. Marcus was waiting already. He had properly equipped a skateboard in his hand. Lucas noticed the design of a magic-based engine to increase its moving speed, but the system wasn't in a working state. It took a few minutes, but Lucas could finish it. He said his goodbyes to Marcus and the Guardian before making his way to the capital. The glow of air around him and the fun of just skating brought a level of fun he hadn't had in a while. It would be a close run, but Lucas was moving fast enough to reach the capital in time. He stood in his containment room and waited for the foundation member to beat him. But then I tried to tell him that the Tribble, as he called him in his report, wasn't a member of the foundation and much less in its containment. But he was certain that their paths would meet again. Though I had left him with that, who knows? The foundation did contain a lot of possibilities to make it happen. Jack returned from the workshop to a secret passage in the office as Amy, Alicia, and Sophia were planning the meeting with the trading company. Surprising to us, as he had told him that he knew the workshop and they didn't even know about the passage, but that was a good thing. It just that they had someone to work with plans, and so a plan was created.